NANGO National Executive Committee, government ministries and departments, development partners, diplomatic community, SADC member states, Africa Union, United Nations, UN family in Zimbabwe, SADC Council of NGOs, captains of industries, political parties, media houses and practitioners, fellow members, colleagues in the entire Zimbabwe. Today I come to you cognizant of the experiences, complexities, anxieties that we were subjected to in the year 2020 owing to diverse factors, but chief among them being COVID-19 pandemic. My name is Ronika Mumbire, the National Chairperson of the National Association of Non-Governmental Organizations, NANGO, which is the umbrella body of NGOs operating in Zimbabwe. I want to acknowledge the NANGO National Executive Committee for ably steering the organization in these challenging times by ensuring that the organization remains afloat. NANGO is a membership-based organization, and our members are spread across the country. We have 5 administrative regions covering all provinces, and these are the Eastern Region covering Manicaland Province, Midlands Region covering Midlands Province, Northern Region covering Mashonaland West, Mashonaland Central, and Mashonaland East provinces, Harare, and also Harare Metropolitan. Southern Region covering Mashingo Province, and Western Region covering Matabeleland North, Matabeleland South provinces, and Bulawayo Metropolitan. Furthermore, for ease of coordination, our members are clustered into 10 clusters, which are the Children's Cluster, Disability, Economic, Health, Human Rights and Governance, Humanitarian, Land and Environment, Media, Arts and Culture, Women and Youth Sectors. NANGO has come of age, having been formed in 1962. NANGO's vision is a proactive community of NGOs responsive, committed to the sustainable development needs of all people in Zimbabwe and the full realization of human rights, democracy, good governance, and poverty alleviation. NANGO's mission is to create and identify opportunities for non-governmental organizations to pursue their visions and missions and to facilitate the building of member capacities, resources, and synergies. NGOs exist to contribute towards sustainable development through various ways at local, national, and national levels. I am sure that citizens have benefited from programs supported by NGOs in the areas of social, economic, environment, governance, humanitarian interventions. Some of the programs include, but are not limited to, providing watchdog on government policies and programs, capacity enhancement on various development issues, support through availing social safety nets to the vulnerable communities, offering legal representation to the disadvantaged, facilitating participation of communities in democratic processes, resilience building through offering life skills and livelihoods programs, among others. During this festive season, traditionally we have time to merrymaking, sharing of gifts, fellowship, partying, amongst others. The spirit of joy and happiness will be hovering across the country. Yes, as a people, we crave and yearn for better life for each and every one of us, no matter our religion, race, color, physical appearances, political affiliation. I come to you as we conclude the year. This is a year which indeed was more challenging compared to the other years, as we were subjected to some unusual experiences and all had to quickly adjust to cope with the presence of the COVID-19 pandemic. The greater part of the year 2020 was characterized by COVID-19, which dictated the actions and outcomes such as how people should live, where they should and should not go, how they should and should not interact amongst others. COVID-19 pandemic worsened the living conditions and standards of citizens and left the majority more disenfranchised and vulnerable. NANGO would like to extend its gratitude to its members who have been complimenting government on the front line of the COVID-19 response as healthcare workers, teachers, essential staff, and caregivers for families and communities. Protecting the lives of people has been top priority for NGOs during this time of the devastating COVID-19 pandemic. This has demonstrated in a profound way the complementary role expected of us as NGOs towards government's development efforts. We have been placing people at the center of all efforts to tackle and recover from the COVID-19 pandemic. NANGO is proud that as NGOs, we contributed and played our part in the response to COVID-19. NANGO will support from UNDP, ActionAid, European Union, Frederick Naumann Foundation managed to set up an NGO COVID-19 coordination and communication platform that was key during the year. Within the platform, NANGO established the COVID-19 Monitoring and Evaluation Committee, Information Dissemination and Documentation Committee, Research Lobby and Advocacy Committee, Coordination Committee. These committees published in vernacular and disability-friendly formats as well. This information was shared through bulk SMSs, jingles, documentaries, e-news, e-news platforms, amongst others. To increase coverage, NGOs facilitated radio programs with both national and community radio stations to share information on COVID-19 across the country. Through the radio programs, NGOs, independent commissions, development partners, and line ministries shared vital information on COVID-19 across areas such as service delivery, social economic rights, national development, conflict prevention and management, resolution and transformation, as well as the role of NGOs in preventing the spread of COVID-19 and helping communities cope with the effects of the pandemic. As we close the year, fellow citizens, NANGO knows that the threat of COVID-19 is still with us, and the current trends show that the situation is worsening by the day. NANGO therefore urges the nation to continue observing the World Health Organization, Ministry of Health and Child Welfare guidelines, and the general guidelines by government to help contain the spread of COVID-19. To governments, NGOs, development partners, and private sector, NANGO would like to acknowledge the commitment, efforts, and great work demonstrated in 2020, but further recommend that there is need to enhance collaborations and partnership in the coming year. COVID-19 response taught us that the multi-stakeholder approach is imperative if we are to contain and extricate the COVID-19 pandemic in our beloved country. Together we can and shall effectively respond to COVID-19. While the COVID-19 pandemic has been a major priority and may continue as such in the near future, we should not be completely distracted from other important issues. According to the Zimbabwe Humanitarian Response Plan in 2020, about 7 million people in Zimbabwe were in urgent need of humanitarian assistance, which shows an increase from 5 million in 2019. The effects of climate variability manifesting through droughts, heat waves, cyclones, amongst others, are making households more vulnerable, both rural and urban communities, and making them more food and income insecure. It is further worrying to note that, according to the 2020 Rural Zimvac Assessment, households saw an average of 51.5% reduction in income compared to 2019. This is evidence of general worsening of the social, economic, and political challenges the general public have been facing even before the advent of COVID-19. It is against this background that NGOs endeavor to contribute towards national development in order to avert the plight of communities we serve who continue to bear the brand of poverty and underdevelopment. National policy development and implementation is key to facilitate sustainable development. Hence, NGOs should ensure full participation of the public during consultations and implementation of these programs. Furthermore, national budget support to the implementation of these should be enhanced. As the transitional stabilization program is elapsing at the end of the year, we note that there are some components of the program that are outstanding. Our concern on the TSP, which we indeed voiced out with the government, was lack of participation of the public in its development. Against this background, NANGO want to acknowledge the efforts that were made by the government in the development of the successor of the TSP, the National Development Strategy 1, where platforms were set to engage and gather the aspirations of the public. Submissions were also sent to the Minister of Finance and Economic Development, and the final blueprint mirrored to a greater extent the contributions made by the various stakeholders. This is a first step towards the success of the National Development Strategy, and we look forward to more platforms during the implementation phase set to ensure public engagement. The success of the strategy is also hinged on the support from the national budget. As such, adequate national resources needs to be raised to support the implementation of NDS1. Our hope as NGOs is that we all work together to contribute towards the Zimbabwe we want, which is characterized by prosperity, inclusivity, and peace. Effective implementation of national development policies will ultimately contribute towards the attainment of the Agenda 2030, the Sustainable Development Goals, and the Universal Periodic Review, which Zimbabwe is a party to. It is paramount for NGOs and the nation at large to have a shared and owned national vision. The national vision guides our character, identity, and values as a people. Zimbabwe is a great nation, and we have what it takes to become stronger, prosperous, accommodative, and inclusive. We are just coming from commemorating the Unit Day, which is a symbol of what we are capable of doing as Zimbabwe when we come together in one accord. Unit is precious. To enhance accountability in the management of national resources, NANGO urges the government to be more transparent in government expenditure through increased public access to budget information, public participation, and enhancing the work of oversight institutions. Good governance is a key enabler for sustainable peace and development. As such, we need to ensure that we are guided by our constitution and we all thrive to live in accordance to it. Issues of human rights abuses, corruption, and selective application of the law have a negative impact on the outlook of the country. Against this background, NANGO urges all stakeholders to ensure that everyone play their part in creating a transparent and accountable society. An enabling NGOs operating environment is important as it facilitates smooth implementation of programs countrywide. The presence of stifling legal and administrative instruments has been one of the challenges faced by NGOs and continues to hinder their development and yet complementary work. The government is currently in the process of reviewing the PVO Act, and our hope is that the reforms contained therein will facilitate rather than stifle the operating environment. As such, increased engagement with NGOs is recommended as a process to enact the bill progress. The government is currently in the process of reviewing the PVO Act, and our hope is that the reforms contained therein will facilitate rather than stifle the operating environment. This therefore makes engagement with NGOs of paramount importance during the process of review. Further, huge concerns continue to be highlighted by NGOs operating at local level, where they are requested to sign memorandum of understanding every year. These have been used to constrain civic space through charging exorbitant fees for their renewal and signing. Increased surveillance of NGOs has also been phenomenon across the country, and this has further compromised independence and freedom when implementing programs. In as much as we are not privy to what the coming year holds for us, we hope for the best. In our hope, we need also to be a nation of action, because hope alone will not produce us the desired results. In 2021, there are key national and international processes that we as a nation need to prepare for. These include the voluntary national review at the high-level political platform, the universal periodic review at the Human Rights Council, and other processes that require us to work together and ensure that no one is left behind. It is against this background that NANGO wishes to say to our government, let the best interest of Zimbabweans preoccupy the government in the year 2021. Zimbabweans need jobs, food, clean, safe water, better education and health services, leisure, social welfare, amongst others. The government should also ensure that the people of Zimbabwe have an identity, enjoy their freedoms, realize their rights, have access to the justice system, are united in the stability, peace and security for all. The government should also ensure full implementation of national commitments, including curbing corruption, impunity and injustice. There is also need to ensure that all government institutions perform their work to the best of their capacities and that they are autonomous, as this is key to enhancement of service delivery across all aspects of life. The government needs to facilitate the implementation of the NDS1 and other sectorial plans to the book through prudent stewardship of the national revenue that will be used to transform the lives of Zimbabweans. There is also need to enhance the multi-stakeholder approach in addressing challenges faced by the nation through creation of platforms where the private sector, NGOs, government, quasi-government institution in the church, labor, political parties, youths, women, persons with disabilities sit on the table for decision making. There is also need to create an enabling environment that facilitates operations of diverse stakeholders who want to contribute towards sustainable development of Zimbabwe through removal of restrictive legal and administrative bottlenecks that exist. NANGO pledges its commitment to be a key player and partner in delivering development, peace, good governance and corruption-free Zimbabwe in 2021. To the development partners who have stood with us throughout the year, your support is cherished and acknowledged. This coming year, we look forward to strengthening our collaboration and engagement and enhance interventions that are key in delivering sustainable development to Zimbabwe. Support around strengthening institutional reforms, responding to the development question of today and enhancing the enabling environment is key going forward. NANGO has nurtured good relations with the private sector, whom we continue to see playing a pivotal role in supporting the work of NGOs through various models, including corporate social responsibilities. We want to acknowledge that role and look forward to strengthening our relations and partnerships going forward. Citizens of Zimbabwe, including communities in hard-to-reach areas, have been very active and took part in national program interventions to ensure their voice is not lost in the development processes, and that public social accountability is not a pipe dream. Their zeal to be part of a better Zimbabwe and their commitment to work is unmatched. To the regional and global community, NANGO calls for your continued technical solidarity and collaborative support in helping Zimbabwe address its structural challenges in economy, social, and governance. At this juncture, fellow Zimbabweans, allow me to wish you all a peaceful festive season. God bless you, and God bless Zimbabwe. I thank you.